addition to your appointment as Undersecretary for Peace and Order, the President specifically gave you so-called operational control, which is not a legal term, or in other words, exclusive jurisdiction over the PNP to the exclusion of Secretary Robredo.
Thank you, Madam Chair. First, I would like to explain the setup of the department. We are two undersecretaries under the Department of Interior and Local Government. The other undersecretary is Undersecretary Ostir Panadero, who's in charge with the local government side, while I am with the Peace and Order side, which takes care of the uniformed personnel that includes the fire and the jail. The setup with regards to the police is I report and represent the secretary and give him advice and give him other reports to the secretary who is chairman of the NAPOLCOM. And the NAPOLCOM oversees the Philippine National Police. While the operational control of the Philippine National Police is with the chief of the Philippine National Police, the Director General there. However, just like what happened last August 18, I get direct instructions from the President to investigate and all of these things I report also to the Secretary.
So let me ask you the categorical question. You are in effect claiming it is not true that you had operational control or any other form of exclusive supervision over the PNP. Is that correct? You deny it.
Yes, Madam Chair.
That's correct. Yes. You had no such exclusive power. All right. Now, let me just add one more question. In your capacity as Undersecretary for Peace and Order, have you ever altered anything that the PNP Chief, the Director General, John, did during your term of office? Have you ever altered anything?
None.
Have you modified anything?
None. All of these.
Have you nullified anything?
No.
The definition of control is to alter, modify, nullify, or set aside. So did you ever set aside anything that the Director General did?
None, Your Honor.
Now, I'm going to later on to bring up the fact that although you're not a member of the Bids and Awards Committee of the PNP, apparently you stepped in during the process and talked to the applicant suppliers. Is that true?
I sit in the Bids and Awards Committee as an observer.
Part
of the my job as the undersecretary also is to monitor and make suggestions if possible, if there are any, if it's needed. But I sit there as an observer.
But what you suggested apparently became the policy of the police in that particular respect. The purchase of the firearms, which we shall come to later.
All final decision is with the Bids and Awards Committee. I am not a voting member of the Bids and Awards Committee.
So the public understanding that you are in control of the PNP to the exclusion of your own secretary is not true. You deny it categorically under oath.
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Just to be safe, may I request all the resource persons to stand up? And Secretary of the Committee, will you please administer the oath?
Please raise your right hand. Do you all swear the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth before this committee, so help you God? Please be seated.
Thank you. Mr. Archbishop, I will now confirm what you have just reconfirmed since 2010. Jueteng is as strong as ever, everywhere in the Philippines, but most specifically in Luzon. Since the PNP has the mandate to prevent and investigate crimes in our country, and since the Undersecretary for Peace and Order has the power of supervision, just the power to see that they're obeying the laws or implementing the laws, then it appears that both the PNP Chief and the Undersecretary for Order and Safety have been remiss in their duties. That is the implication of your statement to us today. And now I just wish to confirm your statement from my own confidential agencies or confidential agents. Yes, there is jueteng. Even after Mr. Puno, you're appointed on July 10. Here is the list. In National Capital Region with 16 cities, 6 have jueteng in full view of the public. Quezon City, Makati, San Juan, Manila, Pasay, Mandaluyong. Out of, I repeat, 16 cities, 6 at least are tolerating jueteng in the sense that they never get arrested. Region 3 in Central Luzon, Bataan, Nueva Ecija, Pangasinan, Bulacan, Zambales, Pampanga. Region 4, 4A, Calabarzon, Laguna, Batangas, Cavite, Quezon Province. Of course, I have sources of information in addition to those that I used in 2010. But in 2010, I said money from jueteng bets are called gross receipts. The biggest gross receipts in Luzon are, in order of amount, on a daily, araw-araw. Here are the gross receipts for jueteng. Laguna, 14 million in 2010, 1-4. Pampanga, 9 million. Pangasinan, 9 million. Batangas, 8.5 million. Bulacan, 8 million. Nueva Ecija, 7.5 million. Quezon, 7.5 million. And then I added this observation. From this intake of money, 34% is deducted as operational expenses, and then the remainder is split on the national level. I also gave what the splitting process involved on the provincial, regional, and municipal levels. But let's just limit ourselves to the national level. In 2010, I said 1% of the net earnings goes to the syndicate consisting of the DILG secretary or undersecretary chief or undersecretary, the PNP chief, and the CIDG head, etc. So, madaling salita, kung ilang bilyon ang kinikita, 1% of that will go either to the DILG secretary or undersecretary, plus to the PNP chief and plus to the CIDG head. Archbishop, in your estimate, how much